disappointed for him because we had a chance there, and that would have been pretty special.
What did you tell the offensive line after that first drive with all those penalties?
Pointed for him because we had a chance there, and that would have been pretty special.
What did you tell the offensive line after that first drive with all those penalties?
Man, if I had a nickel for everything we're doing to try to avoid those mistakes, I'd have a lot of nickels. We got to lock in. I know crowd noise can be a factor. It's a factor in our home stadium, too. But the penalties don't seem to go our way. And we'll just double down again and keep trying to make sure those things don't happen.
Scott, lock extra point. Did you guys consider going for two to make it 14-11 now?
We did. I thought about it. I was thinking about it as the drive was going on, but I thought there was too much time left in the game. I've seen people go for two and not get it, and then trade a field goal for a touchdown, and you wish you had the point back. We needed to go score a couple more times to have a chance to win it anyway, so we talked about it on the headset and decided to kick it.
In the first blush, maybe the emotions here in the first 5 minutes after the game, does your mind go to how you guys competed with Oklahoma or the mistakes that kept you from winning?
Both. Well, the first thing I got to do is congratulate Oklahoma. That's a fine football team with some really good coaches and a bunch of talent. I'm so proud of our players and how they fought and competed with that type of team on the road. I told them after the game, everything they want to accomplish this year is right in front of them. We're going to get more opportunities to win a big game. But if they play like that, like we played today all year and fight that hard all year, we're going to have a chance in a lot of games. And as disappointed as I am, I'm happy for the way that they competed.
It's got the drive right after the long catch by Xavier Betts. Was that the first down inside the 20? Was that a broken play, or were you trying to get a timeout there?
I don't know what happened. We have to talk. I didn't want to burn the timeout, but we signaled in basically trips right, and it either – we called trips right. It either got signaled in wrong or they lined up wrong. And Adrian made a decision not to burn a timeout and to try to get what he could on the play. Those things can't happen, so I don't know exactly what happened. I wasn't watching the signaler, but no, that was costly.
Scott, what do you say to Tom today to have Omar, Xavier, your tight ends back in the offense?
Yeah, we looked different with those guys out there. I thought the tight ends did a great job in the run game. You know, we need to keep putting the ball in the air downfield and back people up. Omar and Xavier are going to help us do that. We were more of a complete team today. We just got finished drives. Seemed like we were handling the line of scrimmage and running on them well until we'd get down inside about the 25 and then move everything the same way. We have some things to fix and a lot of things to build on.
What do you say to Connor? He's been so good last year, and for whatever reason, he's not getting it
done. Yeah, Connor missed a lot of camp with an injury, and I don't know if it's lack of reps or what it is, but I know how good he can be. I've seen it. It was my decision to put somebody else in to kick, and we went with Kellen. It wasn't so much that he missed the kick. It was kind of his reaction after the kick to me. But then he came back in and hit his next one. Kicking game cost us a bunch of points today, and that's happened too often. I didn't know how much attention to the detail in that has been paid by our coaching staff and our team. We've got to get it figured out.
How would you characterize right now, Scott, your level of confidence with the offensive line?
It's work in progress. I know we've got good players up there. Most of them are still young, but we got to move people a little better. It's got to be a little more consistent in the run game. Everything in the offense can work better if we can hand it off and get yards. And yards are tough to get in against a team like this. They're tough to get in the Big Ten with the defenses we see. But we got the guys that can do it. We got to be more consistent.
Did you think your defense coming in could slow down Oklahoma? I think it was the first time since 2016 that it scored 24 points.
Yeah. I didn't know. We had a plan going into the game. We wanted as few possessions for both teams as possible in the first half. And we knew the only way we'd do that is we could control the ball and get some first downs on offense. That meant getting some third downs. I thought we did that well. Thought the defense played a great first half. Thought we got an illegal crackback block on their first touchdown that might have taken those points off the board, and that didn't get called, but I need to see that on tape. Thought the offense did a good job sustaining a few drives. We just got to finish them. But I told the boys that if we came into halftime ahead or right in the game, I thought we were going to win, and we had our chances to.
Is there anything you can share on Gabe?
Yeah, we're going to reevaluate him when he gets back. Looks like he could miss a little bit of time.
How were you guys able to convert so many third downs, especially in the first half?
Hey, we got a pretty good quarterback. He had all his weapons out there. Thought Ramirez played a good game. Some of the receivers made plays. At times we protected better than I've seen us protect. Wasn't happy with the protection, you know, to start the two-minute drive. We were basically in a seven-man protection and can't give those up. We have a lot to work on, but again, we have a lot to build on, too.
What is it about Ramirez that moved him to kind of a leading role there?
All those guys are so even right now that we're letting them compete all week in practice, and whoever practices the best gets to go. And I thought that's the hardest I've seen Ramirez run. He's got speed that makes him a little bit different, and I thought he played a good game.
Scott, this whole last 24 hours, even 7 days, has been sort of dripping with nostalgia. Did you feel a greater sense of opportunity or urgency or expectation from you know, the historical perspective?
I did. I can't say enough about Oklahoma. That was our bitter rival for so many years, but I've talked to people that came down, and they say how well they were treated here. I got a ton of respect for Coach Grinch and Coach Riley in this program. He inherited it from Coach Stoops, and it was in good shape, and he's kept it rolling or improved it. We're trying to get back to that level. I think we showed today that we're close. I root for Oklahoma every time they're playing, unless they're playing us. I think a lot of this team and this place and the people here.
All right. Thank you, Coach. Thanks, guys. We'll bring a couple players in.